गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ फिजिक्स, दैट इज मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. नाउ इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, वी हैव स्टडीड दैट एन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट कैन प्रोड्यूस हीटिंग इफेक्ट, दैट इज वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट जूल्स लॉ ऑफ हीटिंग. इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी दैट एन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट कैन ऑल्सो प्रोड्यूस अ मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट. So this term, magnetic effect of electric current, means that an electric current flowing in a wire produces a magnetic field around it. So whenever electric current flows inside a wire, it produces a magnetic field. And this relation between the electricity and magnet is called electromagnetism. Now briefly, we are going to describe about magnet, poles of magnet, magnetic field and magnetic field lines. And these all terms are very much important and necessary to understand the magnetic effects of current. So in this video, basically we are going to start with magnets and its properties, and in the next video we are going to discuss about magnetic field and magnetic field lines. Now a magnet is a substance which attracts pieces of iron, steel, nickel and cobalt. And it comes in various shapes and sizes. And one of the most common magnet is the bar magnet, as shown over here. This is horseshoe magnet, and this bar magnet is the most commonly used magnet. You can see a bar magnet is a long rectangular bar which attracts pieces of iron, nickel, etc. Now let us talk about the properties of magnet. And you are very much familiar with these properties of magnets. So first is, it has two poles, that is north pole and the south pole. And whenever we suspend the magnet, whenever we freely suspend the magnet or release the magnet, it always rests in the north-south direction. The second one is, like poles repel each other and unlike poles attract each other. This property you have also seen in case of charges. So charges also, same charges also repel each other, and unlike charges attract each other. In the same way, like poles repel each other in case of magnets, and unlike poles attract each other. So this means that north pole of a magnet repels the north pole of another magnet, and the south pole of a magnet repels the south pole of another magnet, but the north pole of a magnet attracts the south pole of another magnet. The next is, they always exist in pair of poles. This means that if we break the magnet from in between, and the two new magnets will always exist in their pair of poles. That means the two newly formed magnet will also have their north pole and south pole individually. Now the next property and the last property of magnet is that repulsion is the only sure test for magnet. So if you want to test that particular substance is a magnet or not, then repulsion is the test for that, not attraction. Now these days magnets are used for variety of purposes. Magnets are almost used everywhere. That is, they are used in radio, television, speakers, refrigerator, doors, video cassette tapes, etc. They are almost used everywhere. They are also even used in children's toys. And magnets are also used in making electric generators and electric motors. Also, magnetic resonance imaging, that is MRI technique, which is basically used to scan the inner human body parts in hospitals, also uses magnets for its working. So this was the brief introduction about the magnets, that what are magnets, what are its properties and where they are used. In the next video, we are going to discuss about magnetic field and magnetic field lines. Thank you.